Wilson Productions and Man for Brusco followers, and those of you who are new to the channels, and would like to get to know what goes on the channels. Anyways, we have a special episode here today, or a special video here today of some things that have happened recently. Yesterday, my parents went to Washington, D.C. to attend the annual Stork Ball. If you don't know what Save the Storks is, it is a foundation for saving unborn children from being aborted and killed. For the past few years, we've been supporting Save the Storks, and over the years, they've done pretty well. God has blessed them in many ways and has gotten them through a lot. They've actually put some Planned Parenthood places out of business and places that abort children out of business, and so that's pretty cool. Anyways, the Stork Ball, it started last year. It started last year with the first time. Sadly, me, Joel, and Sam didn't get to go. It's only for people who give donations to Save the Storks, which I don't have credit cards yet. So. I don't donate yet. But my mom and dad did, so they got to go to Save the Storks Ball. Anyways, a lot of popular people showed up and discussed what their thoughts were for Save the Storks. They made donations, made a lot of money that night. Praise God for that. Anyways, they just put their backs behind Save the Storks, saying, "We got your back, and we're willing to help you. We're willing to commit to helping save unborn children." Moving on to this year. This year, quite a bit of people were meant to show up at Save the Storks Ball. The main person who I saw on the list was Stephen Curtis Chapman, and he did show up. Sadly, my dad didn't get any footage of Stephen Curtis Chapman. But it's okay, though, because it's still pretty cool. Anyways, Kirk Cameron and Matt Hammett showed up again. They were there at the Stork Ball, and Diamond and Silk, they were that YouTube channel that made the videos about common sense and the Democratic plantation for black people getting killed, and they were put in court for that. And they were there at the ball, and we had a special guest. There was a special guest there too, which I will not reveal yet. You'll have to watch the footage to see. Anyways, I'm gonna stop talking so you can see it.
You're gonna have all of me. You're gonna have all of me. Cause you're worth every falling tear. You're worth facing any fear. You're gonna know all my love, even if it's not enough. Enough to mend our broken hearts. But giving you all of me is where I'll start.
The roads are really icy on the way to Washington, D.C. In Maryland, there was a hoar frost, that's what they told me. And from the footage, it looked pretty white. They got to Washington, D.C., and they had to go halfway across town to get to the hotel where the ball was being hosted at. You want to know what hotel they stayed at? Yeah, they stayed at the Trump Hotel International. That's where the ball was hosted at. Yeah, they stayed at the Trump International Hotel. That sounded pretty cool. I was kind of jealous because I didn't get to go, which is sad. I really wanted to go to Washington, D.C. and meet these people. But the main point of this ball was to support and give charity to these babies that haven't been born yet, that haven't had a chance at life yet, and hoping that they do. God willing, hoping that they do.
Welcome to Save the Storks Ball. This is January 17th, 2019. And the most beautiful woman in the world is right here at table 4. My very own Nellie Wilson. And I'll let you take a look at all the stuff. This is before everyone's getting here. This is and the Trump International Hotel. And this is a fundraiser for Save the Storks. They do this, well, this is the second year in a row. And these tables will be filled. And we're not about saving the storks, we're about saving babies. We can save the babies and the storks can keep delivering them. That's what Save the Storks is all about. And they buy vans to help women see their babies before they're born and help them take care of them if they can't. There we go. Second annual Stork Ball. What's that now? International Hotel, January 17th, 2019. Just attended the Storks annual ball, Save the Storks. And this used to be the old post office in downtown Washington, D.C. Now they've turned it into a hotel called the Trump International Hotel. And we were just gonna walk down this large hallway.
Before my mom and dad left yesterday, it was a one-night thing, so they came back today. Before they left, though, we had a little chat, like, what if Trump showed up there, like, and I'm like, are you sure? Because I didn't think Trump was going to show up there. But he's like, you're not supposed to know where President Trump's going to be. We had a little chat, like, what do you want me to tell President Trump for you if I see him? And I'm just like, well, Trump 2020, and a friend of our family was on the phone with someone else, and the one on the phone, actually, we know her too, She said, fire Pelosi and keep making America great again. We thought that was funny. Anyways, it wasn't President Trump who showed up.
Joe Baker, Philip Isaacs, Victoria Robinson, the whole team that saved the Storks, and to all you dreamers, doers, and adventurous souls who made this evening possible, we're the Pences, and we are honored to be with you for the second annual Storks Ball.
Was the vice president who showed up, Michael Pence.
I have to tell you, we don't always get to do things together, so I'm just so excited to be here with my wife of 33 years. She is a lifelong educator. And just this week returned to the classroom to teach art at the school, where you join me in welcoming the second lady of the United States of America.
Vice President Pence's wife is going to be teaching at a Christian school now. Second lady, teacher of the day. Woohoo! You could hear my dad doing that. It was kind of funny.
Saved the Storks. Has saved 5,000 lives.
Awesome.
We just came to say thank you. But while we're here, let us also bring greetings from a friend of ours. Just left him a few minutes ago. He happens to be the 45th president.
And last but not least, he had to give a tour, a Cribs tour, of their hotel room in their stay at the Trump International Hotel.
This is the Trump International Hotel, room 310. Hopefully someone will let us in. Wow, fancy meeting you here.
Welcome to our suite.
Cool. That's like the amenities thing. And there's some coffee, apparently. And this is a lovely lady called Nellie who's here to show us around. Oh, there's a... That's like in case you guys want to like tie up with the other room. Like if you have somebody who's staying next to you. Like maybe if we bring our boys here in the future. And then this is the walk-in closet in the room 310. And then like we got our stuff ready to go, but we wanted to show you guys the room. So here is, well, there's the bathroom. We got the towels thrown all over the place, and but anyway, that's real marble, and the floor is cold because it's marble. And just make sure you got the heat turned up when you go take a shower, because it starts out cold. And then there's a TV we never turned on. And we got like TV table, big chair that Nellie was liking to sit in. And then we've got a bed that's huge. By the way, the sign of a good hotel is that they have a Gideon's Bible in the drawer. And they do, right there, Gideon's. That's good. They got cool pens. I took the pen. I asked them, and they said, yeah, you can have the pen. Okay, so then there's Nellie in the chair. Now, this is what I'm going to do. Look up. The ceiling is like 12 feet high or something. It's huge. And this is the old post office building in Washington, D.C. And we've got a little room here. We've got outside, we got Washington. It's like rainy and kind of moving on icy. And there's the rest of the post office building that we're in. Second tallest structure in Washington, D.C. because Washington Monument's the tallest. But we're good. And then, like, so here's like automatic switches right there that like open the screens or the thingies. See, look, they're opening. Isn't that cool? There we go. So then that opens. That's pretty neat. Yeah, don't try to open them yourself because you'll break the motor. Anyway, there is a building next to us. I don't have any idea what that is. But if you, actually, I think that's just the rest of the hotel. It's connected over there. Inchway. That is the room for the Trump International that we stayed at for Save the Storks Ball. And we're getting ready to leave because we want to go back home. Ready for Shabbat. Anyway, see y'all later. And by the way, here now, I guess you can take a picture of me so everyone knows that I was here. I was the guy holding the camera. So if you see like Mike Pence, and you're like, he wasn't there with Mike Pence, and I go, well, yeah, I was, because I was the one holding the camera. Vice President Mike Pence, not as big as he looks on TV, but still as cool as he looks on TV. And it was someone, his wife going back to a
teaching
school. I don't know how that's going to work in the Secret Service, but it's kind of cool. She's going to go teach at a Christian academy. And that's awesome. And Mike seems like a genuine Christian in person as he does on TV. Anyway, you know, see you guys later. We're going to try to come home.
Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, everyone. And make sure to hit that like and that subscribe. And make sure you comment what you want us to do in the future, what content you want us to what content you want us to post out there in the future. And we will consider it if it is appropriate, of course. Appropriate always counts. Anyways, have a great day, and make America great again. See y'all later. You're gonna have all of me. You're gonna have all of me. 'Cause you're worth every falling tear. You're worth facing any fear. You're gonna know all my love, even if it's not enough. Enough to mend our broken hearts. But giving you all of me is where I'll start. I won't let sadness steal you from my arms. I won't let pain keep you from my heart. I'll trade the fear of all that I could lose for every moment I'll share with you. You're gonna have all of me. You're gonna have all. It's where I'll start.